We will begin Mass this morning with hymn number 886, 886 from the hymn book. Can I invite you please to stand?
For the healing of
Welcome to our celebration of Mass today. It's the 23rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Welcome if you join us online. I'm going to begin with an apology. I'm really rather unwell today. I'm not well at all. Father John was able to celebrate the vigil Mass for me last night, but there's nobody else today. So I'll limp through, so please forgive me if I'm a bit subdued. The prescription is a short homily, so maybe we'll all enjoy that. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
The Gospel is challenging today. It asks us how we live our Christian love, and sometimes that involves hard truths as well as easy choices. To celebrate worthily, we call to mind our sins, and we ask God's pardon. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. We make our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
The first reading is a reading from the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord was addressed to me as follows. Son of man, I appointed you as sentry to the house of Israel. When you hear a word from my mouth, warn them in my name. If I say to a wicked man, wicked wretch, you are to die, and you do not speak to warn the wicked man to renounce his ways, then he shall die for his sin, but I will hold you responsible for his death. If, however, you do warn a wicked man to renounce his ways and repent, and he does not repent, then he shall die for his sin, but you yourself will have saved your life. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh, that today you would listen to his voice, harden not your heart. Oh, that today you would listen to his voice, harden not your heart. Come, ring out your joy to the Lord. Hail the Rock who saves us. Let us come before him giving thanks. With songs let us hail the Lord. Oh, that today you would listen to his voice, harden not your heart. Come and let us bow and bend low, let us kneel before the God who made us. For he is a God and we the people who belong to his pasture, the flock that is led by his hand. Oh, that today you would listen to his voice, harden not your heart. Oh, that today you would listen to his voice, harden not your hearts as at Meribah, as on that day in the Massah in the desert, when your fathers put me to the test, when they tried me though they saw my work. Oh, that today you would listen to his voice, harden not your heart.
The second reading is a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Avoid getting into debt, accept the debt of mutual love. If you love your fellow men, you have carried out your obligations. All the commandments, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not kill, you shall not steal, you shall not covet, and so on, are summed up in this single command. You must love your neighbour as yourself. Love is the one thing that cannot hurt your neighbour. That is why it is the answer to every one of the commandments. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We stand for the gospel.
Alleluia. 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 consecrate us in the truth. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, "If your brother does something wrong, go and have it out with him alone, between your two selves. If he listens to you, you have won back your brother. If he does not listen, take one or two others along with you. The evidence of two or three witnesses is required to sustain any charge. But if he refuses to listen to these, report it to the community. And if he refuses to listen to the community, treat him like a pagan or a tax collector. For I tell you, whatever you bind on earth will be considered bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth shall be considered loosed in heaven. And I tell you solemnly once again, if two of you on earth agree to ask anything at all, it will be granted to you by my Father in heaven. For where two or three meet in my name, I shall be there with them." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I've mentioned the name of Dr. Sheila Cassidy before. She was a human rights activist, a doctor. She was imprisoned and tortured in Chile under the Pinochet regime. And when she returned home, she became the champion of the hospice movement. So she's a lady who knows quite a lot about living at the hard end of life's edges. She said, "The difficulty with the gospel and its challenge to us is that we think love is an emotion rather than an act of the will. The prophets didn't find it easy to challenge, just as those who were challenged by the prophets didn't find it easy to hear. And the early community found it difficult to challenge, just as those who were challenged by it found it difficult to hear. Sometimes we need to say difficult things, but if we say them in love, perhaps they are easier to hear. And sometimes we need to hear difficult things, and sometimes if we recognize the love with which they're said, it makes it slightly easier to hear. The love that the gospel speaks of is not an emotion, but an act of the will. So for every challenge that we might have to make, and every challenge that we might have to hear, let's ensure it's with love, with an act of the will, and not just an emotion." To make known our needs and prayers in the presence of God, we stand.
Bless the Church in her universal mission and make her open to receive all who care. Give to her ministers the spirit of compassion and wisdom to discern the needs of those who turn to them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Have mercy on all in the world who seek for help and are uncertain of their direction. Open the ears that have not heard the words of salvation, and loose the tongues that have not learned to praise. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Bless our families with health and strength and with grace to acknowledge the great mercies that we have been given. Help us to know and to relieve the troubles of those we meet in our daily lives. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Have compassion on all sick children and on the parents who grieve for them. Come in mercy for the healing of any who are afflicted in hearing or speech. Give skill and wisdom to those who work for their relief. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the departed, who worship not through the ears and the tongues of flesh, but in the fellowship of the Spirit. May they rest and rejoice in eternal life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. To these our general intercessions, we add prayer for our own local and particular needs. We remember those who have asked us to pray for them, especially those whom we know to be in particular need at this time. Pray for those who join us online, particularly if they are caring for others or are unwell themselves, either as carers professionally, as their vocation in life, or for members of their families. For ourselves and for each other, that we may recognise the act of the will that is required to love those who are difficult to love, and to hear words which are difficult to hear, though they are said in love. And we pray finally for our dead. We remember those who've died recently, especially Tommy Hunter, and those whose anniversaries occur about now, especially those we've been asked to remember in prayer. That they may all know the presence of God. Lord, hear us. God, our Father, you call us to be your people, to gather together with one voice, so that you hear and answer our prayers. Be with us this day and always, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Stand and pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to you, and by partaking of these sacred mysteries, we may be faithfully united in mind and in heart. Our prayer we make through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For whenever your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of your Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, so that your people, formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as your church. And so, in the company of the choirs of angels, we praise you, and together with all the saints, with joy, we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, John, our Bishop, and all who minister in your church. Remember our brothers and sisters fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, St. Joseph, our spouse, the apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to life eternal, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
For the coming of God's kingdom, we pray in the words the Lord Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Grant that your faithful people, Lord, whom you nourish and endow with new life through the food of your word and this heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your Son's great gifts that we may merit an eternal share in his life. Our prayer we make through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Can I invite you to familiarise yourself with all the latest notices in the bulletin on the website, on the Facebook page. Thursday of this week, we celebrate as a diocese a mass for prayer for vocations awareness, and there's an opportunity to gather together with the bishop in the cathedral at 7 o'clock on Thursday, so we will go to that. I'm taking a busload from St Benedict's, so you'll be very welcome should you wish to go. Next weekend, Father Flynn will preach the mission appeal on behalf of the Holy Ghost Fathers, the Spiritans. So I'm taking opportunity of him being here to go on retreat. Someone said to me, "What do you mean, go on retreat?" I said, "Well, a retreat is a strategic withdrawal to consolidate resources." So that's what I'm going to do. Go away and say my prayers for a few days. So thank you. If you would remember me in prayer, and I'm away, and sorry, I'm feeble this weekend. Thank you for your presence. Thank you if you joined us online. We ask God's blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Please join in with our final hymn, number 898. Number 898.